be he who hides from pomp and power in sylvan shade or solitary bower, where balmy zephyrs fan his burning cheeks.
Clown, king of clowns, leave the stage at once.
Who is it?
It's Cyrano. Afraid he'd do this.
Thrice happy he who hides from pomp and power.
Wretch! Did I not forbid you to appear this month?
Yes, be quiet.
Quiet! Go on, Wolfery.
Thrice happy he who...
He who, indeed. Donkey, say rather hee-haw! Be gone! Or must I come and help you off the stage myself? What? Still there?
Where balmy zephyrs fan his burning cheek.
Fat swine, if you dare breathe one balmy zephyr more, I'll fan your cheeks for you.
Messieurs, if you will protect me.
Proceed, proceed.
Go on.
Sir, I will not allow you to insult me in this manner.
Really? What manner would you prefer?
Quiet down there. We'll tolerate no more of this. Go on with the play, Montfleury.
This is a... Throw
that man! Possession.
Unless these gentlemen retain their seats, my sword may bite their ribbons.
Who is this braggart?
My cousin, sir.
Well, Montfleury, still no exit. Very well, then. I enter with knife to carve this fat, stuffed goose. I pray you do not crowd my scabbard here. She may put her tongue out at you.
Silence! I say be silent! And I offer one universal challenge to you all. Will all who wish to die please raise their hands? Approach, young heroes. I will take your names. To the first man who falls, I'll build a monument. Who will head the list? You, sir? No. You? Ah, no. Anyone? Anyone at all? Not one name? Not one finger? Very well, then, I go on. Attend to me, full moon. I clap my hands three times, thus. At the third, you will eclipse yourself. Ready? One.
How dare you? I demand, I insist, I call upon all the nobles.
Two.
This is an outrage. You hear an outrage. Nothing on earth will move me from this stage.
Three.
Fair ladies and noble gentlemen. Monsieur de Bergerac, why have you done this to Armand Foy, an admirable actor?
I have two reasons, either one conclusive. First, he is an abominable actor who mouths his verse and moans his tragedy. Second, well, that's my secret.
But you closed the play.
It is not a very good play.
Oh, and the mere money? Possibly you would like that returned to these good people. Yes?
Yes. Here, catch.
Well, monsieur, you are hereby authorized to close our play every night on these terms. Ladies and gentlemen, your money will be returned. Kindly pass out quietly. Good night. Good night.
Your cousin is an extraordinary man, madame.
Oh, I agree. Soldier, poet, philosopher, musician, playwright.
All those?
Yes. And the best swordsman in Paris.
Really? Now, I should have thought the Vicomte here had that honor.
Tell me, madame, that comic mask, that nose, presently he will take it off?
No, monsieur, he keeps it. And heaven help the man who smiles. Good night.
Oh, monsieur! Monsieur! When do you leave Paris?
Sir?
Why, after what you've just done to Montfleury, did you not know that the Comte de Guiche was his patron? Who is yours?
No one.
No one? No patron?
I said not.
But the Comte de Guiche has a long arm.
Mine is longer by 3 feet of steel.
Yes, but what a scandal.
You may go now.
But...
You may go. Well, tell me, why are you staring at my nose?
Oh, I was not staring.
Does it astonish you?
Why, no, I've been careful not to look.
Oh, and why not, if you please? It disgusts you, then?
But no, I
never... Does its color appear to you unwholesome?
By no means.
And possibly you find it just a trifle large.
No, small, very small, tiny, infinitesimal.
What? You accuse me of absurdity? Small, my nose? Why, magnificent, my nose. You pug, you knob, you buttonhead. Know that I glory in this nose of mine. For a great nose indicates a great man. Genial, courteous, intellectual, virile. Poetry. Of soul, of picturesqueness, of contour, of character, of nose, in short, as that which at the bottom of that limp spine of yours, my left foot...
Oh, hell! Ah!
Presently, this fellow will grow tiresome.
Oh, he blows his horn.
Well, will no one put him in his place?
Rather.
Oh, well.
Is that all?
Well, of course it
is. No, young sir, you're too simple. Why, you might have said a great many things. Why waste your opportunity? For example, thus. Aggressive. I, sir, if that nose were mine, I'd have it amputated on the spot. Practical. How do you drink with such a nose? You must have had a cup made especially. Descriptive. Eloquent. When it blows, the typhoon howls and the clouds darken. Dramatic. When it bleeds, the Red Sea. Hercule de Bergerac.
Vicomte, come.
Such arrogance, this scarecrow who... Look at him. No ribbons, no lace, not even gloves. Oh, a poet.
Why, yes, a poet, if you will. So, while we fight, I'll improvise a ballade for you, and as I end the refrain, thrust home.
Will you?
I will. Ballade of the duel at the Théâtre de Bourgogne between de Bergerac and a barbarian.
What do you mean by that?
Oh, that? The title. Stop. Let me choose my rhymes. So, here we go. Lightly I toss my hat away, languidly over my... Better for you to shun this brawl here in the heart, through your ribbons gay, in the belly, neath your silken shawl.
Mark how my point floats, light as the foam, ready to drive you back to the wall. Then, as I end the refrain, thrust home. Ho for a to say, so may the turn of my hand forestall, life with its honey, death with its gall. So may the turn of my fancy roam, free for a time till the rhymes recall. Then, as I end the refrain, thrust home. Refrain. Prince, pray God that is Lord of all, pardon your soul for your time.
Watch a fight, or have you ruined if you listen to them. Think of the enemies you've made.
Montfleury, the Vicomte, if he lives. All those foppish. Now dangle a marshal's baton.
Well, someday I will avenge you, too.
Impossible. Come on, let's go to dinner.
Dinner? No, not I.
Why not?
Because I have no money.
I have everything here. Please.
My dear child, I cannot bend this Gascon pride of mine to accept such a kindness.
But I...
Yet for fear that I may give you pain if I refuse, I will take...
Thank you, sir. Good night.
Idiot.
Dinner? Drink? Dessert? More deuce, I was hungry. Abominably.
Tell me.
Anything.
Why do you hate this Montfleury?
A very bad actor.
Come now, the real reason, the truth.
That fat goat. Think a moment. Think of me. Me whom the plainest woman would despise. Me with this nose of mine that marches on before me by a quarter of an hour. Whom shall I love? Why, of course, it must be the woman in the world. Most beautiful.
Most beautiful?
In these eyes of mine, beyond compare.
Wait. Your cousin, Roxanne.
My poor big devil of a nose inhales April, and I follow with my eyes where some boy, with a girl upon his arm, passes a patch of silver, calling myself so ugly, so alone.
But your wit, your courage. Why, that poor child who just now offered you your dinner, you saw it, her eyes did not avoid you.
That is true.
Well then, Roxanne herself, watching your duel, pale.
Pale?
Yes, her lips parted, her hand at her breast, thus. I saw it.
Message for you from a certain lady. She desires to know when and where she may see you privately. She has certain things to tell you.
Certain?
Things.
She wishes to see me?
We go tomorrow.
I'll be there. Me. To see me.
You're not quite so gloomy.
Well, after all, she knows that I exist. Too strong to war with mortals. Bring me giants.
Quiet, please. Shh. We're rehearsing back here.
We're going.
But they're armed. They're cutthroats.
Take this lantern. Forward march. I say I'll be the man that sees you to your shot. Not you. I want no help from anyone.
Against 100, you're mad.
Those are the odds I want.
Risk your life for this pastry cook.
First, because this pastry cook is a friend of mine. Second, because this pastry cook is also a poet. And most important, if anything should happen to this pastry cook, tomorrow morning at 7, his shop will be closed. Good night.
Thank you.
Pleasantly exhilarated. All over.
Really? So soon? Oh, if only I'd had my sword. How many did we kill?
Oh, about eight.
Eight? Eight? Oh!
This gentleman begins to annoy me.
No, the sauce and meat must rhyme. Add a pinch of marigold and thyme. Your house of crust needs a stronger roof. Huh? There's proof. Cyrano! Cyrano! Come in and eat something. Not quite seven. Oh, now, please, Cyrano. A man without breakfast is like...
No. If she has changed her mind...
Oh, she wouldn't dare. We were magnificent.
Pardon, one word.
Yes?
Have you a good digestion?
Wonderful.
Here are some eclairs. Puffs. Some.
But before I dare tell you, are you, I wonder, still the same big brother almost that you used to be when we were children, playing by the pond in the old garden down there?
At Bergerac. Not too plain.
Sometimes when you had fallen or hurt your hand, you used to come running to me, and I would be your mother and say, oh, in a very grown-up voice. Now, what have you been doing? Come here to me.
Such a wise little mother.
And tell me while I wash this blood away how many you played with?
No, about 100.
100?
Yeah, more or less.
Tell me.
No. Tell me.
Someone who does not know.
Yes.
Someone who loves me too, but is afraid of me and keeps away and never says one word.
Yes.
Give me back. He is proud, noble, young, brave, beautiful.
Beautiful?
What's the matter?
Nothing. This, my hand.
Well, I love him, that is all. And I have never seen him anywhere except at the theater.
You have never spoken?
He has only lately come to Paris from Normandy.
So soon. So soon we lose our hearts. But...
Monsieur de Bergerac, I have eaten all the cake.
Good. Now go out and enjoy nature.
They say that in your company, it frightens me. You are all Gascons.
We pick a quarrel with any outsider who intrudes himself. Is that what you have heard?
I am so afraid for him.
Not without reason.
And I thought you, if you whom they all respect and fear...
You want me to defend your little baron?
Will you? Just for me. Because I... 100 men against 1. You shall tell me the whole story someday when we have time. 100 men. What courage!
I have done better since.
Stop them.
Dead men in the street. Scandalous. I fear, in confidence, our uneasy armistice with Spain is doomed.
My Colonelcy?
Your commission has been prepared.
Oh, thank you, Uncle. Thank you.
Well, one thing more, deplorable.
What will you do with him, Your Eminence?
I? Nothing. I thought I might leave that to you.
To me?
Yes. Place him somewhere in your service with a comfortable allowance. He looked a little threadbare.
But Your Eminence, you detest dueling.
Of course I do. Why didn't you prevent it? I should much prefer that Monsieur de Bergerac live by the pen rather than die by the sword. Do you not agree, Antoine?
By all means, Your Eminence. By all means.
And then, as I end the refrain...
Monsieur de Bergerac, I am disposed to forget them.
That is very generous of you, sir.
No, truly. You are, it seems, a man of many skills. A rare combination. He pays well.
Yes, but not so well as I. When I have made a line that sings itself, I pay myself 100 times.
You are proud, my friend.
You have observed that.
Cyrano, see what we found in the street. Plumes dropped in their flight by those fine birds who showed their tail feathers. The man who hired those scoundrels, he must be an angry man today. Who was it? Do you know? It was I.
Sir, will you not return these to your friends?
Have you read Don Quixote?
I have, and found myself the hero.
Be so good as to read once more the chapter of the windmills.
Chapter 13.
Windmills, remember, if you fight with them...
Plume, how do you expect to succeed in life?
What would you have me do? Seek for the patronage of some great man and, like a creeping vine on a tall tree, crawl upward where I cannot stand alone? No, thank you. Be a buffoon in the vile hope of teasing out a smile on some cold face? No, thank you. Eat a toad for breakfast every morning, make my knees callous, cultivate to know his partner's business, takes in the fee? No, thank you. Shall I use the fire God gave me to burn incense all day long? No, thank you. Struggle to insinuate my name into the columns of the Gazette? Calculate, scheme, be afraid, love more to make a visit than a poem, seek introductions, favors, influences? No, thank you.
In my own heart, to travel any road under the sun, under the stars, nor care if fame or fortune lie beyond the bourne. Yet with all modesty to say, my soul be satisfied with flowers, with weeds, with thorns even. But gather them in the one garden you may call your own.
In a word, I am too proud to be a parasite. And if my nature lacks the germ that grows towering to heaven like the mountain pine, I stand not high, it may be, but alone.
Alone, yes, but why go about making enemies?
Watching other people making friends.
Or cartilaginous.
One word, one syllable, one gesture, nay, one sneeze.
And your handkerchief becomes your winding sheet. Come on, Cyrano, your story.
Now, let me see. Where should we begin? I set out with our host to meet those scoundrels, not knowing where they might attack. No lamps in those narrow back... Who is that man there?
A new recruit. Arrived last week.
As I was saying... It grew dark. You could not see your hand before your eyes. I marched on thinking how all for the sake of one amateur poet who wrote a verse whenever he took...
A noseful.
Whenever he took a notion, I might entangle at once. I handed one of them...
A nosegay!
Marcosangly! He went down the rest of the way. I charged...
Nose in the air!
I skewered two of them. Disarmed a third. Another lunged and I parried...
With your nose!
Out of here, all of you. Go, leave me with you. To my arms.
Sir?
You have courage. That pleases me.
Why?
Come, do you not know I am her brother?
Whose?
Hers, Roxanne.
Brother? You?
Well, a distant cousin, much the same.
A
French.
Doesn't know
the please. Word, I apologize.
Well, Roxanne expects a letter.
From me?
Oh, yes, why not?
Oh, no. Well, once I write, that ruins everything.
Why? Be painted sword, your ring to charm the fairy princess. Think, is the prize not worth the danger?
My friend.
My friend.
Oh, I love thee, my darling.
Idiot. There are a dozen ways to read that line. Can't you give it some meaning? Any meaning. Thus do I love thee. 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 Thee, thee.
Who knows your smile has known a perfect thing. You are a white rose wherein love lies in ambush for his natural prey. In the garden of my heart, you are...
As the eagle seeks the sky, as the wave hurtles toward the shore, my heart yearns for you.
Good, good. You know, you're beginning to have a feel for words.
Words, I'm sick of words.
Those are your weapons. How else do you conquer?
Yes, but when? They're fighting in the north now, you know that. The regiment could be called up any day, and I've never even kissed her.
Impossible.
How can you say? How do you know? Cyrano, you have her confidence. You could find out.
Nonsense, I say. Oh, very well. I'll scout the terrain.
But Cyrano, intelligently, discreetly.
Yes,
I... With finesse.
And what do you think of Christian after all these weeks?
He's beautiful and brilliant, and I love him.
Good. Do you find him intellectual?
More so than you, even.
Huh?
Oh, I didn't mean...
No. I am glad.
No man ever so beautifully said those things. Those pretty nothings that are everything. Sometimes he falls...
The matters of the heart.
He does not talk. He rhapsodizes, dreams. Only the other night he said to me, extemporaneously, mind you.
Oh, of course.
Take my heart, I shall have it all the more. Plucking the flowers, we but keep the plant in bloom. Well?
Passable. He writes well?
Wonderfully. Listen now. Knowing you have in store more heart to give than I defined heart room.
At first he has too much heart, then too little. Just how much heart does he?
Sending you kisses through my fingertips. Lady, oh, read my letter with your lips.
Yes, those last lines. But he overwrites.
Listen to this.
You know them all by heart?
Everyone.
Well, I may call that flattering.
He is a master.
Oh, come.
Yes, a master.
A master, if you will. And when do you bestow the laurel wreath? How many prodigies of poesy must this new Hercules perform?
I do not know.
Speak about?
Oh, nothing. And everything. I shall say, speak to me of love in your own words. Improvise, rhapsody.
Still time to learn your line.
No.
I have some brilliant phrases for you. Delicate, sensitive.
No. I'll have no more of it. Taking all my words, my sentences, all from you. Making our love a little comedy.
Don't you...
It was a game at first, but now she cares.
Ah.
Thanks to you. I'm not afraid any longer. I'll speak for myself now.
No, undoubtedly.
I will. You shall see. Me?
You're making a grave error.
Go away.
So be it.
Sit down. There, so. Now, speak to me.
I love you.
Yes, speak to me of love.
I love you.
Now be eloquent, be brilliant for me.
Very much.
I ask for cream and you give me milk and water. Tell me first a little how you love me.
Very much.
Is that all you feel?
Your throat. If only I might kiss it.
Christian!
But Roxanne, I love you.
Again?
No, not again. I know I grow absurd.
And that distresses me as much as if you had grown ugly. Oh, please. gather your dreams together into words.
I
know you love me. Good night.
No, but wait, please. I was going to say...
That you adore me. Yes, I know that too. No,
I...
Go away.
A great success.
Help me.
Not I. Speak for yourself, my friend.
Why, I can't.
Well, at least you know enough to take a woman in your arms.
Oh, Cyrano, please.
What, and make your love a little comedy?
Oh, Cyrano, I cannot live unless I win her back now, this moment. This.
No, go away. You tell me nothing.
Please.
You do not love me anymore.
No, not anymore. I love you evermore. And evermore and more.
A little better.
Love grows and struggles like an angry child. Breaking my heart. His cradle.
Better still. But such a babe is dangerous. Why not have smothered it newborn?
And so I do. And yet he lives. I found as you shall find this newborn babe, an infant Hercules.
Good.
Strong enough at birth to strangle those two serpents, doubt and pride.
Why, very good. Only tell me why you speak so haltingly. Has your imagination gone lame?
It's too difficult.
Your words tonight hesitate. Why?
Through the warm summer gloom, they grope in darkness to myself. Daring.
Why daring?
Because what am I? What is any man that he dare ask for you? Therefore, my heart has hidden behind poetic words and tinseled phrases.
But are they not sweet, those pretty phrases?
Not enough sweet that sicken at pretty words.
Yes. That is love.
Love. I love beyond breath, beyond reason, beyond love's own power of loving. Your name is like a golden bell hung in my heart. And when I think of you, I tremble. And the bell swings and rings. Roxanne! Roxanne! Now I dare say these things. I to you, and you hear them. It is my voice, mine, my own, that makes you tremble there in the green gloom above me, for you do tremble as a blossom among the leaves. You... I have done this to you. I myself. Only let me ask one thing more.
One kiss.
You ask me for...
Yes. That is to say, I mean... How much more than all? I know I startle you. I ask you to refuse.
Why?
Please, John, be quiet.
What is that you say?
I am angry with myself because I know I go too far, and so I...
Sir, I am looking for the house of Madame Roxanne Robin.
This is not the house. That way. To the right. Keep to the right.
I thank you, sir. I shall say my beads for you to the very last ring.
Win me that kiss.
No. Sooner or later. True, that is true. Sooner or later it must be so, because...
Are you still there?
Yes.
We were speaking of...
A kiss.
A kiss.
And what is a kiss when all is done? A vow taken before the shrine of memory. A rosy dot over the eye of loving. A secret whispered to listening lips apart.
Shh.
A moment made immortal with a rush of wings unseen. A sacrament of blossoms. A new song sung by two hearts to an old, simple tune.
Hush.
Why? What shame?
No. No shame. Then come.
Roxanne.
away again.
She lived here, Madame Robin.
Well, I thought you said Roland.
No, R-O-B-I-N, Robin.
Oh, Robin, I say.
I'm too old to chase wild geese. My feet...
Oh, what a shame. However, I'm sure there's someone at home.
What is it?
A letter for the young lady, Madame Roland.
Roland?
Robin.
Madame, a letter for you.
Yes, yes, I heard.
Passing by, cousin, I saw this light.
Some matter profitable to the soul. A very noble lord gave it to me.
What is it?
Father, this letter concerns you. Madame, the cardinal will have his way, although against your will. That is why I am sending this to you by a most holy man. Intelligent, discreet. You will communicate to him our order to perform here and at once the rite of holy matrimony. You and Christian will be married privately in your house. Be resigned to the cardinal's command, who sends herewith his blessings. You're very humble and etc. Oh, this is terrible.
Oh, you're to be the...
I am to be the bridegroom.
Look here, postscript. Give to the monastery in my name 120 pieces of gold.
120? Oh, a worthy lodge. A very worthy lodge. Daughter, resign yourself.
What is that?
Me?
Why, where did you come from?
The moon.
You?
From the moon. I have just returned from the moon.
The fellow's mad.
Like a bomb, I tell you, I fell from the moon.
Now, see here.
I say the moon.
Very well, if you say so.
Thank you.
Raving mad.
Where am I?
My dear sir.
What place is this? What country?
Please, let me pass.
His face.
I wish...
I know. You wish to learn from my own lips the nature of the moon's inhabitants, the character of its surface, if any.
I desire no such thing.
Of course not. Oh, no, in truth. I have my choice of several inventions.
Huh?
Yes, several ways to violate the virgin sky.
Several? Yes, another.
Finally, seated on an iron plate, hurl a magnet into the air. The iron falls. I catch the magnet, throw it again, and so proceed indefinitely.
Excellent. And which did you adopt?
Why none of them?
An interesting idiot, this.
Have you guessed it yet?
Why, no. What is it? Madame, kindly bid your husband farewell. Your regiment leaves tonight, sir. Report at once.
But the cadets are not called.
They are indeed, and under my command. Out there, we may have an accounting.
Somehow that news fails to disquiet me.
Here are the orders. Baron, deliver this.
Christian.
The bridal night is not so near.
Farewell, Roxanne.
Take care of him for me. Promise me never to let him do anything.
Thank you.
besiegers are besieged and starved to death.
Yes, but the Marshal has devised a brilliant plan for bringing in food this very night. Now, see here.
Spare us the details, Colonel. Really inform us when the food arrives.
True, we are hungry. But why blame me? I am only your colonel. Oh, yes, I know you disapprove of me. Call me courtier, politician. Well, I can afford your little hates. My conduct under fire is well known. It was only yesterday I repelled a Spanish attack, pouring my men down like an avalanche. I myself led the charge.
And your white scarf?
Cyrano.
Who is he?
Who is he?
I repeat, Colonel.
And your white scarf?
You heard that episode? Yes, I was so far in advance I was in danger of being captured. But I fought quickly, took off and flung away the scarf that marked my military rank. And so, being inconspicuous, escaped among my own force. Rallied them, returned, and won the day. What do you say to that?
Still, an officer does not lightly resign the privilege of being a target.
How pleasant for you that you are denied that privilege.
Pleasant? Lend me your scarf. With your permission, I will lead the first charge tonight wearing it over my shoulder.
What bluster. You're safe making that offer, and you know it. My scarf...
Spaniards do not know that.
Oh, yes, they do now. And they will attack tonight at this point.
Your revenge, eh?
I make no great pretense in loving...
Yes.
This little spot.
Spot?
Yes. A tear.
It is nothing. A poet, while he writes, is like a lover in his lady's arms. Believing his imagination, everything seems real. There's half the charm of writing. Now, I made this letter so pathetic that while I was writing it, I wept.
You wept?
Why, yes. Because it is a little thing to die. But not to see her. That is terrible. And I shall never... You will never...
Give me that.
Halt! Who goes there?
On the service of the king!
Good evening.
On the king's service, you?
But why did you come here into this danger?
They said in Paris there was no fighting. Besides, it was your own fault. Think of it. Your letters. No, never. Everyone was like hearing your voice that night in the dark, remember? Like your arms around me. I read them over and over. Every page was like... Forgive me for being light and vain and loving you only because you were handsome. For now...
No.
I love you for yourself. For what you are. A love like this.
I want no love like this. I want love only for...
Only for what every woman sees in you. I can do better than that.
No, it was best before.
I do mean that.
Ugly.
Even then. Now are you happy? Going.
I will return in a moment.
Your wife, sir. She goes with me?
No, sir. She remains.
There is still time for her to escape.
She stays.
Very well. Someone give me a musket. I stay here also.
Sir, you show courage.
What? Shall I run away and leave a woman?
Colonel, my compliments, sir. What is wrong?
Wait.
What is it? You look so...
She does not love me.
You think not?
She loves you. Tell her so.
No.
Why not?
Why?
Look at me. She would love me if I were ugly. She said that.
Tired of being my own rival. My secret marriage, that can be annulled.
I beg you.
I want her love for the poor fool that I am, or not at all. Oh, I'm going through with this. I'll know one way or the other.
Captain! Spanish fires are going out.
Begins. I need a scout. Where's Cyrano?
Captain, let me go.
No, my boy. Cyrano knows the terrain. He knows their lines.
So do I. Please, allow me.
Very well. We must know from which direction the advance comes, their weight and numbers.
I understand.
Roxanne.
Cyrano.
Whose child thinks? The word comes hard before me. Say it, I shall not be hurt. Ugly?
Even then, I should love him.
Disfigured?
Or disfigured.
Even grotesque?
How could he ever be grotesque? Ever to me?
But you could love him so, as much as...
Yes, and more.
Roxanne.
What is it? Are they fighting? What is happening?
The Spaniards advance. But there is time. Yes, Roxanne.
But he is dead now.
Why, so am I. For I am dead and my love mourns for me and does not know. We'll never know. I have two deaths to avenge now. Christian's and my own.
Satire for the Gazette?
Yes.
Another glove flung in the face of power? Well, why do you do it, Cyrano?
His sword is still very powerful, my friend.
There are many ways a man can die. Who knows? He may meet with an accident. Soon.
Morning.
Forever?
Was Christian all that?
If you knew him, you would not ask. His last letter still at my heart keeps me warm.
And Cyrano, do you see him often?
Every week. My old friend takes the place of my Gazette. Brings me all the news. Every Saturday under that tree out there, I wait for him embroidering. The hour strikes, I need not turn to look. At the last stroke, I hear his cane tapping the walk.
His satires have made him many enemies.
They still fear that sword of his. No one dare touch him.
That may be so.
It is not violence I fear for him, but solitude, poverty.
Forgive me.
I am here.
Do you know, when a man wins everything in this world, when he succeeds too much, he feels somehow a thousand small displeasures with himself, whose whole sum is not quite remorse, but rather a sort of vague disgust. Dry illusions, vain regrets. Yes, now and then I envy your Cyrano.
It is true that no one has yet dared to attack your friend Cyrano. Nevertheless, at the theater last night, I heard some things. Keep him at home all you can. Tomorrow...
It played well?
Oh, beautifully. They laughed and laughed. How they laughed.
Molière has genius. Christian had good looks. With me, it was always thus. Good night, my friend.
Hold there! You!
Are you addressing me? Detained by a visitor, most unexpected. An old friend of mine, at least a very old acquaintance.
Did you tell him to go away?
For the time being, yes. I said, excuse me, this is Saturday. I have a previous engagement, one I cannot miss, even for you. Come back an hour from now.
Your friend will have to wait. I shall not let you go till dark.
Perhaps a little before dark. I must go.
Oh? Then tell me now the court news, my gazette.
Ah, yes, well, let me see. Saturday the 19th. The king fell ill after 8 helpings of grape marmalade. Grape marmalade will no longer be served at court. Sunday. The royal pulse is now normal. Monday, everyone was talking about the success of Molière's new play. Tuesday, the king fell ill after 6 helpings of marron glacé. Marron glacé will no longer be served at court. Wednesday, the Comte de Fiesque spoke to Madame de Monglas. She said, no.
Cyrano! What is it? Cyrano!
No, it is nothing.
But...
my old wounded Aris, sometimes...
My poor friend.
No, it is nothing. It will soon be gone.
It is hard to read now. Oh, but the blood... and the tears.
His letter? Did you not promise me that someday you would let me read it?
His letter? You wish to
read it? I do wish it. Today.
Open it and read.
Son, because today I die.
Aloud.
I know that it will be today, my own dearly beloved, or with a look that is a kiss. Follow the sweet grace of you.
How you read it, his letter.
I remember now the way you have of pushing back a lock of hair with one hand from your forehead, and my heart cried.
When that letter lying on my breast, your tears. You knew they were your tears.
blood was his.
Cyrano!
Here! He's here!
That paintless, what is it?
Nothing. I did not finish my gazette. Saturday the 26th, an hour or so before dinner, my noble foe, a lackey, my battlefield, a gutter. It seems too logical. I have missed everything. Ivory, when beauty said I love you to the beast, all his ugliness changed and dissolved like magic. But you see, I am still the same.
And I have done this to you.
Later, I feared the sweetheart with mockery behind her smile. But because of you, I have had across my life one whispering silken gown.
I never loved but one man in my life. I have lost him twice.
That you may give a double meaning to your widow's weeds. And the tears you let fall for him may for a little be my tears.
Oh, my love.
No, not here, not lying down. Let no one help me. No one, only the sea. She's coming. I feel already shod with marble, gloved with lead.
I can see him now. He grins. He is looking at my nose, that skeleton.
You there? Who are you?
And my roses. Yet, in spite of you, there is one crown I bear away with me. And tonight, when I enter before God, in spite of doom, mine own, and that is my...